Ladies and gentlemen, we are going live with the last match of the group stage. This is Bliat B facing off against Larrup Gaming again. Gandhi already taking the head of Roku. Good start for the counter-terrorist side. Now the execute onto A comes in. Shadow pushing aggressively towards T-spawn. Bomb is being planted right now. Schmidl protecting his carrier, but getting a shot in the face. Finding Ewald, but gets traded up by DMK. Gandhi from stairs, trying to fight the head of Navarone. Expo finding Brodus Rex. And Expo finding also the head of Xaido. Even on low HP, defuse comes in, full fuse. Kit was available. Don't even need it. First round for Bliat B Rush. Now a conservative buy of Larrup Gaming. Just the Tech 9 armor picked up by Roku. Not sure what he's trying to do with it against only one rifle, one scout, and three. One SMG rather. One rifle and a scout. Three rifles and a scout. Now I got it. Gandhi, however, removing both Navarone and Xaido. Finding Roku. Meanwhile, Schmidl tags up Flea. Down underpass, but the flashbang fully blinds Sim and Expos, therefore the kill. Now, Brahadas with the bomb is kind of stuck between underpass and B. Tries to make his way out, but there's already flank coming in, so he should not have any business in surviving this round. Expo ran down from mid, finds him second frag of the round for him. Gandhi chiming in with the rest of it. And now the buy should come out. Larrup Gaming. Roku, after buying up in the last round, only able to afford a scout. But on the other hand, there is no AWP picked up for Bliat B Rush yet. Flea on a scout as well. Utility is sparse, however, for the CT for the T side. The CTs, however, are fully bought up. As we see a slow descent onto the A side. Roku with his scout is looking for an opening. As Larrup gets toasted just in the action position, but not finding anything just yet. Flea takes down Brujadas, but is traded out by Navarone. Now Roku gets a nade to the face, but finds Ewald. Expo with two of his frags. The M4 chimes in. Schmidl on the flank makes it into a 2-on-2 situation, but the bomb is dropped on top of the boxes. Now DMK finds Schmidl and even gets the second one onto Navarone, who was running out of bullets, I believe. No, he was not running out of bullets. 19 left in his chambers. Not sure how he got this frag. Now Flea upgrades to the AWP and Larrup Gaming is back on an eco. Tech-9s and armor now brought up, so it's less of a save and more of a force buy. But of course, Bliat B Rush not only are 3-2-0 in the lead, but also get the advantage as Axpo takes down Shido. Now DMK takes out Schmidl, who was looking in the wrong direction, and he even pushes up more aggressively. The double stack of connector pays off as Axpo finds Roku again, and it's all down left to Brodus and Navarone to get anything done from underpass. Now DMK appears to be aware of it, spots both players, connects with a solid spray transfer, and finds three frags of his own. Unfortunately, Larrup didn't get the bomb down in the last round. Still they're burning up into everything they can. Tech-9's being bought up, two AKs. Three AKs now that Roku finally got it. But still, utility is sparse again. They do not have much to work with. A singular flashbang now left after one is being deployed. Ewald finds Brujadas. Nice snap from him. Schmidl once again trying to get something done in underpass. But it appears to be that the sniper already has his number. Now the re-molotov of Expo denies any underpass action by Schmidl. And the bomb is slowly but steadily making its way in towards B. Roku finds the head of Gandhi. And now the play is on. Flashbang blinds all of Larrup. As Roku is aiming for the head of DMK and actually finding it. B-sides therefore they're taking. As Roku pushes up aggressively towards the shop where two CTs are already waiting for him. Fleer with the AWP. Staring him down and Schmidl on the rotate off flank. Roku finds Fleer. Finally, but the flashbang blinds him and Expo is able to trade him out. Finding another one inside Expo, but Schmidl is finally there and Schmidl finds his second one. Also retaining the AWP for his team, getting Larrup on the board. And forcing Expo to drop an AWP over for Fleer. Expo finding the head of Roku here as Fleer is pre-aiming Palace but not quite pulling the trigger yet. It's a tight angle to hold for him. Nade explodes over his head but not doing massive damage. His nade on the other hand is landing straight on Chaiko. And Ewald even finding the head of Navarone. Xado now takes down Fleer, drops the AWP. And the bomb is making its mad dash towards T-spawn to get towards the B-side rather. Unfortunately, Brothers is the last one alive in a 1v2 situation. Expo and DMK staying on the A bomb site for the moment. Now they already make their rotate over to A. From A to B. Brothers should technically be faster than him, unless he isn't getting stuck in the window. Now planting safely. Question is, will he not pull in the plant for some reason? Will he be able to prevail against both counter-terrorists? Pushing up at DMK, gets an easy frag onto Brothers. Of course, enough time to defuse the bomb. Just waiting for the AWP to be collected. Kits on both players should not be any problem for them. Thus, completely resetting Larrup. And effectively breaking the economy. Spike 7 picked up for Gandhi, full buy for BlyatBrush on the other hand. Three pistols for Larrup Gaming. They forced into the Schmidt, actually has got an AWP to work with. But the bomb still dropped in T-spawn, it's a quite slow approach here. Expo pushing up, gets taken up by Xido, gun barrel showing. But apparently it is giving away some part of their plan. As they collect the bomb and Ewald gets a fracker to Roku. Nate not connected with anything here. Bomb is pushing up ramp and Xido is actually able to get a frag into connector. Now pushing towards jungle, but Ewald with an extremely nice flick onto Brothers drops the carrier. Xido is also taken down. Leaves Gandhi on the B bomb side, but the bomb is dropped already, not finding anyone there. Now DMK gets a free frag onto Navarone. Round is pretty much over at this point, unless Schmidl can pull off something incredible here. He does collect the bomb. Is he going to be able to plant it though? Looks like he is going for the safe plant towards the default position, but DMK rapidly finds his face. Diffuse comes in, no problem. 3k for DMK. But really, nothing spectacular here to be seen. Larrup Gaming now in quite a precarious situation. The P90 being picked up by Navarone. The Deagle for Schmidl. Attack 9 for Roku. Quite a lot of utility, 4 grenades in total. And of course, the T side is fully bought up. Bradus gets lagged there actually by Ewald. In the smoke, he's down to 7 HP. Roku once again lurks towards the underpass, should hear the scout, the scope rather, of Flea. And indeed he does. Shoots him in the face with his Tech 9. And advances from there on towards Connector. The bomb, however, is making its way to B. Presence given away, now two players still on the side, and Broadus is still lurking towards Sandwich. Maybe they can outfake someone. Expo taken on Broadus, who was already very low. And Schmidl may not expect another angle by Ewald there. But he just unscopes and finds a nice headshot onto Expo with his Deagle. Ewald missing a shot onto him in return. Thus he makes it out alive, but Gandhi is already expecting the play into jungle. Smoke cover is quite good. Bomb is being planted on the B side. DMK, however, finding Roku and finding Schmidl. But they think it's an A plant and they still haven't realized. Now they got the rotation is on, but time is ticking down for them. Of course, they all equipped with kits. And the P90 of Navarone is going to get action soon. Gandhi now approaching the side. Will he check the bench position? Shadow tags him low, but can't get the job done quite yet. Time is incredibly low. Navarone, however, is picked up and they should have the defuse. Nope, they don't. Was close. But nevertheless, killing 3 CTs actually with it. Quite a good round. Still, money is a little bit scarce for Larrup as they only get their second round on the board. Still, they do have, for once, the superior buy against BlyatBrush. Nice dunk nade onto Roku, taking him down to 70. It's quite the heaviest hitter of their utility now used up. And Roku jumping over towards stairs. Ewald shooting him in the back, easy frag for him. DMK hearing the bomb running through underpass. Question is, will he check it? Jido packs him down. Schmidl gets a frag. Schmidl with another one. Navarone also chimes in, but Expo trades out Schmidl. A 2-on-2 situation. Gandhi now finds the head of, or the body rather, of Navarone, leaving Bruhadas with 8 HP. In a 1-on-1 against Gandhi with his UMP, who only now picked up an AK. No armor for him, but frankly this shouldn't matter at the amount of HP. He unfortunately thinks it's an A play for Bruhadas, but he is making its way into B side. And if he accelerates just slightly, he should be able to get his check in his corners. Of course, he is very anxious that Gandhi might be lurking somewhere. Now, stick in the plant. Finally, no more place for him. Going back into the apartments. Now, Gandhi should maybe get aware of this as soon as he sees where the bomb's actually planted. Question is, will he check this very position? Gandhi approaching it. But Broad is actually being able to close it out. And, well, he should have time for all the defuse. All has been defused. Counter-terrorists win. BlyatBrush forced up again, of course, breaking the economy of Larrup. We see five rifles picked up for them versus the 5 Tech 9s, no armor. On any other player here. Now, DMK is getting a little bit scared, but there is no one actually there. Four players, in fact, stacked up towards the A. Now, he is contesting mid. He was spraying through the smoke, not connected with anything just yet. But BlyatB reading this quite well. Already on the rotate, finding all the frags they need. Bomb is dropped now by Fleer. And will they close it out now? They will. DMK gets a frag onto Roku. Larrup is back on the bottom, but losing the first pick already. Now, the 5 rifle buy, of course, for them, no money for any AWPs on either side. Schmidlenov flashing up and not connecting with anyone. Expo should spot him there, even though he's tagged quite low. There is a flank coming in by Brodus Rex and his teammate on the bomb side, but they'll run into Gandhi. Gandhi with two of them shuts that down. Fleer finding this, making the ninth on board for BlyatB against Larrup Gaming. Another Tech 9 force up here for the terrorist side. They did not have much success with that recently, as Brodus elevates the bomb to a higher position. They do have a few smokes, and I'd like to see them go for something more of a set piece towards the A side. And indeed it comes in, the wall of smokes is being deployed. He was being tagged by Schmidl. Taken down. Expo looking completely in run range, and all the picks are going in favor of Larrup Gaming. Well, not anymore. KingQueen, or DMK rather, finds Brodus. But it's a 4v2 situation still. Gandhi, torch on fire. Finds Xaido nevertheless. But Schmidl takes him down, and Roku closes it out in style. Stuck in the window. DMK is unable to do anything, giving Larrup Gaming a third on the board, and it's another chance to win this. Money is relatively low, BlyatB still decides to buy up here. Drop a rifle over to Ewald, but this depletes their bank almost entirely. We see an SG picked up for Brodus. Not quite sure what he's doing with it. Let's find out. The bomb is headed towards B, firstly. Nades, of course, not connected with anything here. Brodus lurking behind the smoke to catch anyone off guard. Ewald in the sandwich position finds Schmidl, who's got a Molotov in his hand. Unfortunately for him, he's been taken down, giving BlyatB once again the advantage over Larrup Gaming. Now the T's slowed down quite significantly. Roku gets dropped by Fleer. Grenades, of course, being traced back to his position. And unfortunately, that's the bomb loose as well. Expo spamming away with his USP. Then following up with the AWP. Actually finding the third one as well. This is a good play from him. Money, of course, shattered now in this 14th round for Larrup Gaming. They still decide to force up. Brodus only on Tech 9, the rest ones force up at least body armor and some upgraded pistols, two AKs. Versus Oh, bye. All of it off BlyatBrush. Now, they still slowed down quite significantly. Three people stacked towards the B apartment. Two maybe run interference on A. And BlyatB has not adapted to this quite yet. Of course, they can't know that. So maybe we're in for a little bit of a flank. As Fleer tags down Schmidl incredibly low. Head showing there for Navaris, but the upper can't quite connect just yet. Gandhi flashing his way into lines. Two T's fully, capitalizes on both of them. Now the bomb is going towards A. Ramp out of ramp already. Nate not connecting with anything just yet. Ewald is tagged very low. Schmidl finds Fleer, who misses his orb shot. Ewald, however, responds onto him, gets traded up by Navarone. 2v3 for the T's. Bomb. Can't be planted quite yet. Expo trades with Navarone. Leaving just Navarone on 6 HP. For the plan, getting shunned back by Gandhi. Good stuff by BlyatBrush. Now for the last round, there's not much to buy up for Larrup Gaming. We see once again the Tech 9 armor combination. An MP7 brought up brought as Rex, another Tech 9 and an AK. Facing off against, of course, a fully bought up BlyatB. They may be a little low on utility, but frankly, against this kind of buy, it should not be too much of a problem here. DMK finds Schmidl as Gjaido leaps out of connector, but Ewald pins him to a wall. DMK trades with Navarone, who fought Gandhi off first, and Roku gets the knife frag onto Ewald. Fleer trades him immediately. Brothers actually manages to capitalize on the scope of the open connector. However, with 12 HP and a full minute to play with, there's doubtlessly much you can do about it. Now, Brothers lurking his way actually into jungle. There is a player already staring him down. Expo, he should have heard that one. In fact, they may have just missed it, but no, they're spraying in. They definitely saw him. It is entirely possible for him to at least get a bomb plant, but Expo already getting the angle onto him. However, Brodus is not actually thinking about going B. He outfaked them quite well. DMK will still have the superior angle though, making it incredibly hard for him at his low HP to get out there alive. 9 seconds now, he has to plant the bomb immediately. The CTs, of course, know that and should be too late now. DMK denies the plant. That's the half done and dusted indeed for BlyatB with a 12-3 scoreline. We see four sets of armor and one stack of utility picked up for BlyatB, who goes straight towards an A play. Five sets of armor, no defuse kits, no utility on the counter-terrorist side of Larrup. With three people being stacked up into Palace, I'd like to see more of an aggressive play towards the A side. The CT is already hunting for information and not seeing anyone so far, making it possible for them to shift three people over to the A side. Navarone gets two people for the price of one, essentially. Schmidl chimes in with another one. Trades been over the place and they all favor the CTs right now. Fleer tagged very low, dropped the bomb, and is now dead. Nice little hold there from Larrup Gaming, reading this situation quite well. And we see the force up for BlyatB coming in, an AUG already picked up in the second round by Brodus. Two rifles, an MP9, a P90. frankly, at this point in time, with this many rounds on the board, or this little rounds on the board rather, for Larrup, I can actually accept this as a buy because they won't get many chances afterwards. Let be hitting the braids quite nicely stacked up, gaining some basic map control towards TF's, one towards Palace, and Neverone gets to feel that quite fast. Expo shoots him in the back. Spam it away at Broadus, gets a second one, basically for free, being tagged down to 30, but frankly, his job is done. He is doing very well so far. Now the B side, absolutely free. Expo finds another headshot onto Schmidl, making it the third of his round. Will he get any more? At the moment, it doesn't look like it. Flea finds the head of Roku, making it a 1v5 situation. No weapons picked up just yet. Flea finds his MP9. And it's all on Xiaidu, who frankly should not be going for this. There's too high of a risk to take him down with a single deagle shot. However, he is contesting, finds Flea, finds the second one, drops the bomb carrier, but Gandhi trades it out. Once again, good force up from BlyatB. And now, with this force buy being won by Blyat, money is not only looking terrible for Larrup Gaming, but they also only have two rounds to spare before they're being, well, choked out. Well, counter by them, Roku with a scout plus body armor. Actually bought off a 5-7 as well. We see one other set of body armor and a helmet. Won't do too much against the AKs of BlyatB, who went straight for the full rifle buy. On the hand, just upgraded pistols for the rest of Larrup Gaming. The dunk nade onto Neverone finishes him off, takes Roku. We do have a timeout, maybe that's a technical issue. As Gandhi finds Roku, shoots him in the back, Expo takes on Broadus. Nice pick of Xaidu onto Gandhi, but there shouldn't be much left. Ewald takes him down, basically upgrades his pistol. Good stuff by them. Freeze time, of course, now coming in. With one player dropped, there is going to be a technical timeout, rather. And if we just look at the money situation here for Larrup Gaming, we've got, so far, two SMGs, a Deagle, 5-7, and the Scout with this SMG player at $650 to spare. So if they actually get to win this, they may have a chance. But if they don't win this force up, it's absolutely GG for them. Four rifles already picked up. Can't actually see if there is a rifle dropped for Flea. It doesn't look like it at the moment. Some nice banter there about team chat. Anyway, round is live. Wait for them. Timeouts are being resolved. DMK contesting in mid, facing off against the scout. DMK with a nice nade. Actually doesn't get the frag to follow it up, but Schmidl is taken down to half. Expo finds Xiaidu. They will have spotted the bomb, but Roku still chatting in. Gets shot in the face. Ewald finds Broadus, and this is looking quite terrible for Larrup Gaming. DMK finds Neverone. Schmidl actually gets attacked with a scout. Nice movement by Flea there. Finding out Schmidl. Money is looking terrible for them, only dropping one kill. One player maxed out at 3k. Against a fully bought up terrorist side, there is not much Larrup can do about it. This loss would most likely also eliminate them from this tournament, so they are fighting for dear life here.
nice.
Little flash of Schmidl onto Expo and DMK, but unfortunately they spray him down. Flea finds Broadus. Even though he is tagged quite low, it's a 5-on-3 situation. Bomb is only now being picked up towards A and carried back immediately. With two defenders stacked up on A and one already lurking in jungle, this splitting the defense and isolating the B player. This is a hard sell. Expo finds two heads and now it's all or never with his UMP. DMK is spamming away with his deagle. Gandhi finishes it off with a knife kill. This is GG for BlyatB. They won all their group games. Now heading into the semifinals with a 3-0 scoreline. Also qualified are Here for Beer with a 2-1 scoreline. Tripolowski dropping no maps as well so far and overrated with a 1-1 scoreline, tied in the smaller group, which is Group 2. We'll keep you posted for the semi-finals once they come up. If you are, however, interested in more action from this tournament, from this whole party around here, you absolutely should check out twitch.tv/LukaLeander. I linked that down below if you'd like to check out the League of Legends stream. And I'll see you in a few minutes.